so this don't hurt.
I did. It's not good though.
That's where I'm so confused with the system, because I'm like, okay, what's my
lot of things in my mind that have been huge for so long, going, you don't say that.
Thank you. And then we're gonna reach those legs up to the sky. Just really flex your feet, reach your heels past the circle. And if you want this to be more intense, keep the legs straight or straight-ish and pull with the arms. And hold. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Untuck your feet from the circle. Tuck that circle next to your reformer. And then bring your toes to the bar. Back on bicep. If you bring your headrest to where you want it, just bring your toes to the bar. Feet are about hip bone distance apart, parallel. Find a halfway lift into your heels. Neutral spine. Inhale, push all the way out. Exhale, pull all the way in. All the way out. All the way in. Start to feel the lower back, you're welcome to imprint. Extend the arms up to the ceiling. Let's do a few chest lifts first. So baby breath in, exhale, chin to chest, curl up, and then lower your head, neck, and chest back down. And again, we exhale to curl up. Inhale, lower it down. On your next one, we're gonna curl up and hold. Relax the shoulders out of the ears. Single leg stretch. So hug your right knee into your chest. Reach your left leg out to 45 degrees. And then we switch. Let's go for four, three, two, one. Double leg stretch. Hug both knees into your chest. You're gonna reach both legs over the bar. Lift your arms up to frame the ears. Circle the arms around. Hug the knees back in. So inhale, reach everything long. Exhale, circle the arms, hug the knees in. We're here for four. And three. Two. And one. Extend the legs up to the ceiling. Single straight leg stretch. Grab onto your right calf, lower your left straight leg down to 45 degrees. Pulse the legs away from one another and then switch. And we've got four. Three. Two. One, meet you with both legs reaching up to the sky. Lower and lift. So find Pilates V. You're going to lower those straight legs down to 45 degrees without swinging. Lift right back up. If you need to lower your head, neck, and chest, this is the exercise to do it. You're always welcome to grab onto the pegs beside your ears for a little more stability as well. Give me two more. Nice and slow. Slow it down. Good. One more. And then everybody meet you with your legs in tabletop. If your head, neck, and chest is lowered, we're gonna curl up and place your hands behind the base of your skull. Extend your right leg out to 45 degrees, twist to the left, crisscross. Come through center, switch your legs, switch sides. And we're just here for four, three, we're done in two, and one. Bring your legs to tabletop, lower your head, neck, and chest, and release your heels to the corners of the bar. Open the arms wide out to the side with your palms facing up. Relax the shoulders back and down. Find your position to drop your knees to the parking lot and step to the mountainside. And then use your exhale to pull your knees through center and over to the other side. One more on each side. One more in each direction. Two You're welcome to pull your legs to tabletop if you need like an in-between. Right? Almost there. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it. Curl up an inch higher. Get all of that air out. Lower all the way down. Get out. Big deep breath in through the nose. Exhale, chin to chest, all the way up. Beautiful. And we're going to dismount from the reformer. I think I want to plank on the mat today. Let's step off.
I think I want you to plank
on. Step off your reformer. And we're going to walk back to the spring walk. Turn your back to the spring walk. We'll do a few roll downs first. Okay? Feet about hip distance or shoulder distance apart. On your exhale, nod your chin to your chest nice and slow. Roll forward and down. Really feel your spine articulating down. Good. As you roll down, you should be feeling that length through the back side of your body, right? So like your hamstrings as well as your lower back. From here, I want you to draw your belly button in. Nod your chin to your chest. Slowly peel it all the way back up. Good. Once you're at the top, we're going to take a big deep breath in, reach those arms up. And now if you want a balance challenge, I want you to float to high heels, right? We're going to keep the arms nice and active, which means as we roll down, I want you to keep the arms lifted as if you were reaching for the center aisle, as if you were reaching for the top of the mat, right? Draw your belly button in, keep those arms active, start to flex forward, and as you roll down, keep those arms lifted as if you were reaching for the center aisle. From here, I want you to think like a cartoon character that got punched in the stomach. So nice and round here. Smooth your belly. Look up towards your belly button. If you're still on your tippy toes, maybe you can lift your heels a little bit higher. Good. And just hold. Hold. For 5, 4, 3, 2. Lower your heels, fold forward. So just reach the crown of your head down toward the floor. Good. And now from here, you can grab onto opposite elbows and sway side to side. Maybe you let the arms hang heavy. Maybe you draw circles. Do what feels good here. And when you are ready, I want you to release the arms. Bend your knees as much as you need to put your hands down onto the mat. Walk out to your plank. You are welcome to drop to your forearms. You do not need to stay on your hands if that's not within your practice. All right? Find your plank. Pushing the mat away from you so you're not collapsing down or forward between the knees. Alright? Glutes are nice and active, and we've got a little tuck of the tail underneath us. As always, if you still feel the lower back, just keep your back flat, but you're welcome to elevate your hips a little bit higher. Remember that a modified plank is still a plank, so if you need to, knees can come down, you can shift the hips in alignment with your shoulders and knees. Good. And we breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth. Good. Nothing special. floor away from you. You can do it. Pulse those hips. For three, two, one. Rotate to the floor. Hold it for five, four, three, two, and one. Deep breath in, and on your exhale, you're going to sweep that right arm straight back. we're gonna switch sides. So grab onto the left strap. Scooch forward here.
Oh, sorry, that was for you.
Draw your belly button up in, and from here, we're gonna sweep down the left arm. Straight back and up. Good. And really do your best to keep that arm as straight as you can. Okay. We'll go for four. And three. Two. This time we're going to move into a bit of extension, right? So we've got one handle or one strap in each hand. Legs are about hip bone distance apart. If it doesn't bother your back, you can squeeze the inner thighs together. Again, have to get your glutes up, but your legs start to lift up behind you. Take a big deep breath in. And on your exhale, we're going to sweep those arms back and up. Lift your heart as you sweep the arms back. Good. As you sweep the arms forward, flex forward with the box. And again, we sweep the arms back and we lift our heart. Sweep the arms forward, flex forward over the box. Let's go for four. And three, if that extension bothers your back, maybe you keep your back flat, maybe you stay neutral. Two. On this next one, can we sweep those arms back and hold? Lift into your swan. Draw your belly button up and off the box. And I want you to swim with the legs, as if you were swimming away from something. Right? And instead of thinking about bending at the knees to swim, think about squeezing the glutes to swim. For eight, seven, six, keep reaching those arms back. Last three, two, one, bend your knees and relax. You can windshield wipe the legs side to side and hang the straps up. We're going to sit ourselves up and face the mountain side on top of the box. You do best in however you feel the safest here. We'll take a little bit of side bend. So nothing crazy. Once you're here, if it's available to your body, you can put your heels on like the black part of the carriage and just pull your toes up so your feet aren't sliding. Otherwise, your legs can dangle off the side, but maybe you just cross your ankles. Right? You're going to reach, grab onto this back strap, the one that's closer to the front of the studio. Right, you're gonna take that strap. It's gonna go on the arm holding the strap. You're gonna pull that long loop up over your bicep. So it's going up over like the crook of your elbow. And then from here, hands can go behind the base of your skull, or you can bring your hands to your forehead, right? Relax the shoulders, sit up nice and tall. Draw your belly button up and in. We're gonna side bend toward the center aisle. And back to center. So we think up and over toward the aisle. Back to center. And I like to have my hands behind the base of my skull because it helps me keep my chin off of my chest. So think about pushing your head back into your hands. Right? Let's go for four. And three. Two. One more, and then we're gonna restack our spine. Unthread your arm from the strap, and you can hang that strap up. Several sections down. From here, we'll do that again on the other side. Reminding you to fix your green shirt because it fell off. All right, if you're going to grab onto the back strap, the little lizard in the back of the studio. Bring that long loop over the crease of your elbow. Hands go behind the base of your skull. Put your head back. Relax the shoulders here, and we side bend up over towards the center aisle, and we reach down. Keep pushing your head back into. walk up close to the foot bar. We're going to do a lunge series, but we're going to have the magic circle here. So, imaginary magic circle. Take the magic circle in your hand closer to the foot bar, closer to the reformer. You're going to take one pad of the circle and push it against the foot bar, and the other pad of the circle is going to go like against your palm. All right, so that's where we're going. From here, you want to walk up close to the foot bar, foot that's closest to your reformer, so that's your right leg. It's going to flex up against the shoulder, not the knee.
Take it down and hold it here. All right, from here, I want you to pulse in on that magic circle. So press, press for 6, 5, relax the shoulders. Last 3, 2, hold it here. Now we're gonna pulse the lunge. So down an inch, up an inch into that standing leg. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it. I want you to sink into your deepest lunge here. Your best lunge that you can hold. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All the way up. From here, bring that magic circle with you to either kneeling or sitting on the reformer facing the center of your eye. We're gonna do some single arm work. So kneeling or sitting, that's up to you. If you need a knee pad, you don't have one. Alright, if you're kneeling, feet are gonna be flexed up against the shoulder blocks behind you. If you're sitting, just scooch back so that your back is still.
Reach those arms out, deep breath in, exhale.
to center, sit back on your heels. Worry for a second. All right, we're gonna step off to your right, to your neighbor's mat side, and we're gonna do that lunge series on the other side. You're gonna hold that magic circle in your left hand. Press that pad of the circle against the bar. Other pad of the circle is gonna be against your palm. Left foot up against the shoulder block. Right foot is on the floor next to your foot bar. We're gonna push the carriage out and then sit down into your lunge. Try not to hike that magic circle or shoulder up into your ear. Stand right back up.
Just to get close to you.
And then we'll lower those legs down to 45 degrees. Then you're going to use the tabletop and push right back down. Pull your legs to tabletop, reach the legs up to the ceiling. From here, we're gonna lower one leg down to 45 degrees and then switch scissors. Switch. For four, three, two, and one. From here, go ahead and pull both of your knees into your chest. You can actually keep your left foot strapped. We're gonna reach back. We're going to drop up our right foot. If you find that this setting is too light and it's starting to lift off your back, you can step and change your springboard posture a little bit. Alright? Take a moment, find your neutral spot. Remember this brings you a very light to great. So inhale, you're going to lower those legs down to 45 degrees and then lift your legs back up to 90. And anytime we do the spring lighter or heavier, especially with the feet strapped, it's always wise to let finding your range of motion. Because your range of motion here on this super light spring is probably not the exact same as your range of motion on a heavier spring. Right? Because this is more out, it takes a lot more control. It works with pulling your spine and all that. So really take your time here. Thank you.
no idea.
Yeah.
I was literally staring at it. Just the green.
I've never had to fix another one. Oh, thank you. You think so?
Yeah.
What made it so?
This never ended. Right.
She said it was a 1.75 today because it never ended.
When you've got heavier spring settings, it's just a little bit more support for the abs, and you tend to feel, not really on a red and a blue, but like if you were to do two reds, I'm sure you'd notice, like you tend to feel inferior on your eyes more. The lighter it is, that support has to come from you, so it's more.
Family reunion, you know, when it comes to family reunion stuff, everybody's trying to be budget friendly.
Yeah.
We can't count everybody properly.